heard my octave playing in Valet Dobermann from Liszt. Today I'm going to tell you how you can practice octaves. We first start with our hands on the keys, and just in a relaxed way, you put your hands on the keys and let your fingers stay relaxed on the key. Then try to push the thumb and the fifth finger just a few millimeters, and you have to feel like you squeeze it a little bit. Just like this. And you can do it slowly, whatever you want. Okay, that's the first step. You have to have the feeling that you squeeze. You don't take the grip in your hand and do like this, not like this, but just relax on the piano and squeeze a little bit, like this. The next step is that we leave our wrist at the same place and we push back our hand and the fingers are relaxed. And then let your hands fall down and your fingers relax, fall on the key. Don't bother where they fall exactly, just practice this movement, like this. Okay, and then you spread a little bit more, like this. But still, your hand stays relaxed. You use just push up and let it fall like this. Okay, then we're going to the next step, which is that we do the same, but we are going to take the octave, but you can also, when it's too big for you, take a smaller grip, like the sixth, like this. And squeeze a little bit the thumb and your fifth finger. I take now the octave, I go a little bit to the right, and we let our hand fall on the keys, like this. And when you have pushed the keys a little bit down, make sure all the other fingers are relaxed. Okay, the next one is we're going to move aside. You do like this. Then you move a leg a little bit to the right and you do exactly the same movement on the next octave. When you want to go to a black key, you move forward with your hands and do the same. Everything stays the same, like this. Go back and let your hand fall down. And don't bother about more or less noise. The most important is that you feel the grip in your fingers. You have to be aware of this because this is making your tone. When you don't just like this, you don't have the feeling for to make a tone. And it's important that you can exactly know how strong or how soft you want the tone to be. So that's more easier when you have the grip. So you can do like, or softer, whatever. That's why that is very important. Okay, we're going to the next step. If you want to play a little bit faster, our movements get smaller, of course. You when you play like this, you notice you can't go up like this. You have no time. So, but the movement in essence is the same movement you make. And every time you notice, the hand is relaxed. I can do it more slowly. It's important to squeeze a little bit because we want to be able to, for example, play the fifth finger a little bit stronger because you have in the soprano, it's often used that this has to be more strong than the thumb. So you want to be able to make a difference between those two. When you play like a grip, it's much more difficult to make a difference. So when you look like this, you can also do the thumb, whatever you want. The fifth finger will be more of use, of course, in the most pieces. When you go faster, the movement is, of course, less, like this. And still, you squeeze a little bit. And you relax, you see, every time your hand is immediately relaxed. When you play one octave, just one, you notice your hand and your fingers are immediately relaxed. So that's very important when you have to play many octaves, because it's otherwise it will be very exhausting to do it. When you want to play with more sound, so you want to play stronger, you can do the same principle, but you use your arm also, like this. Like. And you notice the sound is really brilliant, like this is the difference between when you start from the keys. You have a completely different sound. But it's less risk when you play in a concert. It can be challenging to do it like this. That's more difficult. And when you play it just from the key, then you know for sure you have the right key. So you have to choose what you do at that time. But when you want to have a brilliant sound, I prefer more loose. Both arm, both the hands, and then relaxed. And you can control your sound also, because you have to learn how to use the fingers, the fists, for example. When you want to do, when you want to play the fist finger more strongly, then you have control over that. Not like this. That's, you know, you do like this. That's not the way to practice the octaves with, how do you call it? Relaxed and with a good sound. So at least try to relax your hands in between, because it gives you much more possibilities. As an example, we will show you now the video from Liszt again, and with a slow motion video in it, so you can exactly see how I played those octaves. And it's not perhaps the only way, but I think it's a very good way to practice. And for me, with my small hands, it was really the solution to play it and to be able to do it for a longer time, because it is very exhausting to play, of course, many octaves behind another. And for me, it was the solution. So I hope for you too.